The Triceratops was alive almost at the end of what we call the Cretaceous period. This animal was buried in the channel of a river, so probably quite quickly. A big dump of sediment or sand washed down, covered the whole carcass. Because of that, the remains have stayed all together, and we have a fossil that was found more or less in life position, all of the bones where they were when the animal was alive. It's something we call an articulated fossil.
The way that we think about our work is that we're always projecting, you know, 100 years into the future. Because when a fossil comes into the museum collection, it's entered into the collection for perpetuity. You know, the concept is that it's here forever. People can assume that because a fossil is so old that it is very stable. That's not always the case. Fossils are, you know, made up of a composite of minerals, and some of those minerals will oxidize really badly when they're exposed to oxygen and moisture.
All of the organic tissues, the nutrients and blood cells and things like that, those all go away. That empty space can get filled by new mineral-rich fluids from the environment around it. As these fluids pass through the tiny little microscopic spaces inside the bones, they'll leave behind the kind of minerals that make the bones heavier. They go from being bones to fossils.
Despite the fact that they are often very heavy and bulky, particularly for, you know, things like a dinosaur, they are remarkably fragile and quite brittle. Often they're quite fractured or crushed or distorted, which means that there might be a whole, you know, network of microfractures through the fossil.
We know that Triceratops must have been buried quickly. The flesh and blood and tissue had all decayed away, but there are still patterns of its scales impressed into the surface of the sediment and its bones.
Something so mind-blowing about soft tissue being preserved in rock, like, yeah, it's pretty amazing. But you can definitely see the texture of the skin, and that's, you know, there's so much about these animals that are so mysterious still. It's very exciting.